both unbeknownst to each other, fell in love with this book at their finest hour and a half. And Stephen, usually very good at detecting things, found out that I was the other person competing for the book. And we know each other of old. And he called me up and said, we've got to do this together.
Amanda actually worked with me on Interview with the Vampire and on the post-production of The Crying Game. So we've known each other for a very, very long time. And when I found out with Amanda was complete, I rang up and just said, this is completely crazy. In fact, we made Fever Pitch together all those years ago. So I said, why don't we just do it together? Which was great, and it was a real joy. And it was really, we were both fell in love with Lissa's book, to be honest. Producers always act like it's a matter of life and death. We've got to get our money, we've got to get our star, we've got to get our look. Oh my God, we've fallen through, or what are we going to do? But actually, when they made films in the 40s, it was a matter of life and death. They had no idea if they were going to have a film set the next day, whether they were going to have any actors, whether the Germans had invaded. And these films were little love letters to America, please come and help, please come and help. And also at the same time, trying to keep the people living through the Blitz in London, in Coventry, in Bristol, across Britain. You know, keep them happy, keep a smile on their face. How can we do this? How can we make films? So for us as producers, we think we have challenges. But when you look back at the writers and producers and directors and actors in those days, my God, they had challenges. It was an incredible time. And I'm just so proud to be associated with a film, having made films like Absolute Beginners and Mona Lisa and The Crying Game and Scandal and all those movies I made, which were about London, which were all sort of love letters to London. It's so great to make a film that's really about filmmakers and filmmaking at a time when it was a matter of life and death. And that's an important factor for us, for both Amanda and I, when we were making this film, is that, you know, they look a bit corny, those films now, but actually they were so important. 30 million people a week used to go to the cinema. That, you know, that's never going to happen again. I mean, this was the golden age of filmmaking and film going, and people needed those movies.
In the film, in the storytelling, about trying to keep to the truth of the story and find a way to tell that truth in an accessible, enjoyable, delightful way that also satisfies the Ministry of Information in this particular guise, or the American distributors in this film as well. Those are the things that I think people respond to. It happens in this story that her truth is that it's the two sisters, and the two sisters are the heroes of the piece. And that has a lovely, in a sense, feminist sort of influence on the film. But in fact, it's about finding the truth in your story and holding true to the centre of your story and taking that through to the end of the film.